Hello everyone, welcome to Google Partners Next. My name is Scott Christopher, and I'm a Community Marketing Manager for Google Partners. As I was preparing for this event today, I really started thinking about my father. My father owned a small company in West Michigan, and as I grew up, I watched him struggle to find the customers that he needed. He often would go door-to-door or reach out to his friends to try to find the customers for his business. I really wish that my dad could have attended an event like this today so that he could learn about all the great tools that there were and there currently is to reach out to your customers where they are when they're searching for you. Today we're going to first talk about how you can remain competitive in this ever-growing online space. And then after that, we're going to talk about the specifics of how your Google partner can help you connect to your customers online. I want to remind everyone to use the hashtag PartnersConnect today. Share your thoughts and your pictures with us. We always love to see them. Now, we're going to get started. Our first speaker is Todd Rowe. He's the Managing Director of Channel Sales. He has a true passion for small business, which I really saw as I was talking to him earlier. He sits on the board of a couple startups, as well as helps out venture capital firms. And as I was talking to him, it was clear that his passion has always been for small businesses, and that he really loves pushing them forward. He also shared with me he is fluent in Spanish and Portuguese. He stopped by last week to film his session earlier. I've already seen it, and we have some great stuff coming up. Now I'm going to pass it off to Todd. Take it away, Todd.
Hello, my name is Todd Rowe. I'm the Managing Director of Global Channel Sales here at Google. On behalf of Google and our partners, I'd like to welcome you here to Partner Connect. As we talk to you today, we'd like to talk to you about using technology to help your company grow and thrive. And to start, I'd like to ask you a question. As you look at your competition, who is your competition? When I ask that, usually small businesses will say, well, it's a company just like me, just down the street, in the same city, or in the same state. That's great. But if you think of your digital presence, what technology allows you to do, in expanding and promoting your business throughout the U.S., on a worldwide basis, your greatest competition really is no longer just that local company. It is market awareness. Competition in terms of having companies and people know about you, who you are. Part of our objective today is to help you in terms of how do you leverage technology to address your greatest competition in the digital age, and that is market awareness. One of the great things about technology itself is it levels the playing field. Historically, you'd see very large companies doing marketing campaigns effectively. They would have a significant amount of resources, experts within their company, and funding to be able to do incredible marketing campaigns. Well, that's great, but that meant that this was left in terms of the hands of the privileged few, the large companies. Now with technology, it democratizes this and levels the playing field for the rest of us. We can have that same type of effective website, online presence, or marketing campaigns just like these big companies here. This truly is a David versus Goliath story. And you and I all know how that David and Goliath story ends and who wins. We would like to help you leverage this technology and use it to your benefit to level that playing field against your competition and win. Let me share with you some interesting statistics. Did you know that in the U.S., literally 97% of people who look for local product do so in part online? They'll do research and they'll try and find products just like yours by going online. That means it's a great opportunity for you. But at the same time, another statistic, only 37% of small businesses have a website. Just 2 out of 5 small businesses have that website itself. What a huge contrast, almost 100% of all people going online to look for local products, and yet only 37% of small businesses have that website. The question is why? Well, we think that there are perhaps 3 reasons as to why that is. One is in terms of time and perceived complexity and cost. In terms of time, we recognize that almost every waking moment of a small business owner's time is spent in building and running and managing their business here. They don't have a whole lot of time to be able to do that. We recognize that. Second one is in terms of perceived complexity. In some cases, the products and the technology can be complex. but in some cases also it's more the perception of this must be tough, it must be challenging to do, and therefore I'm not even going to try and do that. The last one is in terms of cost. We recognize that every dollar a small business has is sacred, and therefore every dollar investment that you have has to have a positive return on investment. That's why in many cases
every
Google
8 minutes
works
a child
partners,
goes to the emergency
where if you don't
room
have
for
the time,
poisoning.
They can do
the
this
Coles
for
care
you.
Safety crew and
if you have
Children's
that
Hospital
question of why this is just way too complex, you can work with experts
dial,
to do that. In terms of cost itself, both Google and our partners have certain packages and offerings that are more economically reasonable for small businesses to work with. So we try to address each of these in terms of time, cost, and complexity. Now, how do we do that? Three things, in terms of our products, in terms of support, in terms of working with partners. Let me talk briefly about each one of these. While Google AdWords is our flagship product, it's made and can do a number of different things for small, medium, and large-sized businesses. In some cases, small businesses want to start with something a bit more straightforward. Therefore, we created a product called AdWords Express, where literally, with a few clicks, you can have keywords, have your own digital marketing campaigns, and get those launched immediately. And even for companies who say, you know, I've got a website, not ready yet for digital marketing or digital campaigns, but I want to do more than that. We have Google My Business. It's free and available to you that you've been working with right now. The second thing that we do is in helping in terms of customer support. Literally, any customer, no matter how much they invest or how little they invest with Google technology, we support you. It's a 1-800 number that you can call and get support whenever you need. Answer your questions and be able to leverage Google technology to help you. Last is in terms of our partners. We have a significant partner program working with advertising agencies, with resellers, companies who are trained, certified, and supported. These effectively are experts in digital marketing who where they work with a number of companies just like yours and help them grow their business by virtue of technology. And that's how we address these three barriers here. For our products, what we offer, and the partners who you are working with or potentially could work with. Well, that all sounds well and good, but I'd like to take you through two examples of family-run businesses and how they use technology to help their businesses grow and thrive. The first one is a company called Ricochet. It's a family-run business that's been around for three generations, done very well. They sell spare parts for all-terrain vehicles, and they've worked well in an offline world for quite some time, but they wanted to expand their business. So they first created their website and saw some good response from that and said, I want to do even further. They created their first AdWords marketing campaign. Within a few months, they were pleasantly surprised to see customers coming in, not just from their own state, but other states nearby, and said, I want to do even more. So they invested more with their marketing campaigns over the next coming months and saw customers coming from Europe, from Asia, from Latin America, from all over the world, quite literally, and they never would have had these customers or this incremental revenue if they'd not taken that first step of creating a website and having a marketing campaign digitally to expand their business literally to the world. Let me share with you another example, this time from the services industry. This is a product called Aurabrush. It was developed by a doctor called Dr. Wagstaff. He was convinced that it was a great product for people to have. It's a tongue cleanser. And he tried doing things with TV, radio, and broadcast, but it just wasn't giving the impact or the results that he wanted it to. And so he went to the local university, Brigham Young University, and spoke with some business students there and said, help me out. I got a great product, but I want to be able to do something with it more effectively. And some of the business students had said, well, you could try these things of offline advertising, some other things with the product. There were a couple people who had said, you ought to try online advertising and consider doing this from a video standpoint. So they see this service and this product in action here. They said you may get about an 8% lift or an 8% reach here. Some of the students said, well, 8%, what? That's not that much. But their response was, 8% can be very significant if it's sufficient volumes there. So Dr. Wagstaff took the risk and said, I'm going to invest. He invested less than $1,000 to create this video. And this video went viral here and completely changed his business. He saw his business double and triple and quintuple by virtue of having this video. It's now something you can find. You can go to the local drugstore at CVS and you'll see the Aurabrush product that came from that. Now, my challenge to you today is through this event with Partner Connect, get smart, get involved, and get started. In terms of getting smart, my challenge to you is first, get to know all the different technologies that are available, but available and that have been made specifically for small businesses. Secondly, look at examples from companies just like you, just down the street. What are they doing? And learn from them. And lastly, consider working with a partner who has the expertise, who's been trained and certified to help get you up and running as quickly as possible. My second challenge to you is get involved. Number one, get an online presence with a smart website. Number two, drive traffic to that website from advertising online. Number three, go mobile. Your customers are mobile, they'll find you via mobile marketing campaigns. Number four, video. Seeing is believing. If they can see your product in action from YouTube video, that's fantastic. Number five, analytics. Every dollar you invest is precious. You can measure the impact, the results, and the reach from your marketing campaigns with Google Analytics. So use analytics. Lastly, get started. As we talked about today, your greatest competition is market awareness. Having companies not only in your own state and country, but around the world know about you. Your greatest challenge in addressing that competition and market awareness is getting found. That means having a website, a web presence, and digital marketing to drive traffic to that website. We've talked before about 2 out of every 5 small businesses in the U.S. have a website. If you're one of the 2 out of every 5 that have a website, fantastic, congratulations. If you are not, if you're part of that 3 out of 5, you're a competitive disadvantage. We want to help address that with you. There's a market opportunity, but it's a market opportunity that is closing. As we've said, 97% of people who look for a local product are doing so online. In most cases, they're going to find that local product. The question is, are they going to find that local product that they're looking for from you or from your competition? We want to help you get that online presence and so that they find you and your product. And if we can do that, that is success for Google. So let's get started.
Thank you, Todd. If you haven't been able to watch the Aura Brush video, be sure to watch it. It's been interesting to attend this event because over the past few weeks, the 2 students that made the Aura Brush video have been getting quite a bit of press. They have now started their own companies to help other businesses use similar tactics to spread videos online. Our next speaker is Frederick Vallis. Fred is the AdWords evangelist. He travels around the globe, reaching out to customers to share his love and passion for AdWords. I've been able to introduce Fred a couple times, and every time I introduce him, he shares his story about how he got started in AdWords, and it really is a great story. Thank you for being here, Fred.
Thanks for having me, Scott. Good to see everyone. So yeah, before I came to Google and was the evangelist, and my story was that I was an engineer working at Sagan in the middle of the dot-com bubble. And as you all know, the dot-com bubble was bursting, so I ended up losing my job in 2002. And I took my severance check and I decided the best thing that I could do with that severance check was to spend the whole amount on the most expensive digital camera that I could find. And I was going to become the first digital wedding photographer in the Bay Area. Now, I thought I was doing the right thing because I had done family weddings before, so I knew what I was doing. I had the best equipment that money could buy. But the one thing that I forgot about and I didn't have were customers. Now, lucky for me, in 2002, Google just came out with a self-service advertising product called AdWords. And it really was a David and Goliath story because if it hadn't been for AdWords, I really couldn't have afforded to advertise. It would have been too expensive for me to place ads in a newspaper, on the radio. Remember, I took my whole severance check, spent the whole thing on the most expensive camera. But thanks to AdWords, where I could pay on a cost-per-click basis, I could choose my own keywords, I was able to grow my business and I started doing pretty well. But I looked at Google and I was like, this is really amazing. For me to be able to start a business in a couple of months and have so many customers, I want to know more about this company, Google. So I looked at them and I decided to join them. And I was lucky because they needed someone who had a very special skill that not many people in the Bay Area had, and that's the fact that I speak Dutch. So I came to Google, became the evangelist, and got to do a lot of sessions like these ones, where I talk to people about my experience in marketing and hopefully tell you some things that you can do to help your business as well. So for the next 20, 25 minutes or so, here's the agenda of what I'd like to cover with you. First, we're going to talk about connecting with your customers. And then we're going to talk more about what's happening in mobile. Todd referred to this, mobile is growing like gangbusters, so we definitely need to take a look and see what's going on with that. And then finally, if you're going to be spending money as a business on advertising, you want to make sure it pays off for you, that you have a positive return on investment. And Google has some very special ways that make it possible for you to get those measurements and know exactly what's happening with your advertising. So let's finish up with that. But first things first, the reason I think that you all decided to come to these events today is because you want to grow your business. And if you want to grow your business, that typically means connecting with new leads, new prospects, new potential customers. And like Todd was saying, 97% of people, when they look to do business locally, whether that's something like buying a fridge which they're going to pick up locally, or finding a local service provider, 97% of people make online part of the research process. And guess where people go when they do online research? Probably come to a page like this one. It's Google search results. I'm sure you've seen it plenty of times yourself. But the reason I want to start with this page is because I want to level set. I want to make sure we're talking about the same thing, you know what the different elements of this page are, and the different opportunities that exist for you to have a presence on a page like this. So let's start with the first things first, the keyword. Now, it's almost Valentine's Day, right? So I'm going to frame this in the context of Google being a matchmaking service. And that may sound a little bit unusual to you. Maybe you haven't heard about Google as a matchmaking service, but that's exactly what they do. The consumer, they come to Google and they type in what's called a keyword in the search box. And based on that keyword, Google knows what that consumer, what that user is looking for, what they need at this moment in time. And then they matchmake to a business that's able to provide that service, that product, whatever it is that consumer is looking for. So that's also called the moment of relevance. When you as a business connect with a consumer who's looking exactly for your thing, there's no better time for you to make that connection and to potentially get a new lead. Now, the most prominent thing that you see on this page here is actually an ad. A lot of people don't really understand what are ads on the page, what are the organic results. So if you come into this and you say, well, you know, the most important thing to my business is to have the best organic listing. Well, look at this page. Yes, you can see the first organic listing just below the ad, but the number two listing is not even on the page. It's below the fold, so you'd have to scroll to see it. So if you were thinking about the Google search results page and how to dominate it, but you were thinking about it the old way, you'd be missing out a lot of opportunities because it's this ad here at the top. And this ad, by the way, is taking advantage of a lot of extensions. So they've got a review rating. They've got a location extension, they've got site links, they've done all sorts of things to really give the consumer more information about what it is they can do. In this example where somebody is looking for Home Depot, it's really great because Home Depot has a sale going on. And consumers probably don't know about the sale, but Home Depot has taken the opportunity to highlight the fact that that's maybe one of the things that could be most interesting to the user who is looking for the Home Depot. So now they have an opportunity to click on that link, find out more about the sale, and hopefully go in and buy something. Now, the other thing I'll call out here is that when it comes to the keyword is under your control. You as the advertiser, you as the business, you get to choose what your keyword is going to be. But you have to put yourselves in the shoes of your users. Here's a story. There was an insurance company, and all the bigwigs of the insurance company, they sat together in the room and they said, we're going to come up with the next set of keywords that we're going to advertise on. And so they came out of that meeting and they were all proud of themselves and they said, we're going to advertise on the keyword recreational vehicles because that's something we haven't done yet. What's a recreational vehicle? Motorcycle insurance, boat insurance, RV insurance, those are the types of things that people type in. You and I, we're not going to type in recreational vehicle insurance. That's jargon, that's slang for that specific type of business. So put yourselves in the shoes of your users, figure out what they are likely to put into the search box when they need your service or your product, and that's going to enable you to show up to those consumers at that time with an ad and then also with a bunch of extensions. So let me talk a bit more about these ad extensions because these are really cool. The ad extension is a free way that you can enhance your listing on Google. Now, people often talk about Twitter and how difficult it is to have a message that resonates in 140 characters or less. Well, guess what? An AdWords ad only has 95 characters. You get 25 in the headline, you get 70 in the description. So it's even more restrictive in terms of what you can say. But Google has done something and they came out with these extensions. So in addition to the 95 characters of text, you can put in a ratings extension, you can put in a location extension, you can put in a site link extension. And these extensions really make the ad more useful. Now, so the example I show here on this slide is three ads. I've called out the number two ad on this page because it stands out the most. It's not in the best position. It's not necessarily paying the most money, but it is the most prominent because they've taken advantage of all of the extensions that are available. And so Google has around 11 ad extensions that you can add to any of your AdWords ads today, and that generally has an increase in click-through rate of 30%. What does that mean, by the way? Click-through rate is how many people click on your ad for every time it's shown. So basically, this is saying for the same ads, just by adding a free extension, you can get 30% more leads coming to your website and connecting to your business and potentially becoming your new customers. Now, that's the Google search results page. The other thing we should talk about and that Todd started introducing is Google My Business. And this is really if you want to get in front of the consumer when they're not necessarily on the search results page. Maybe they've pulled out their phone, their tablet, they're going to Google Maps, they're going to social networks like Google Plus, and so they're doing other ways of researching. Well, you can appear to those customers as well, and you don't even have to do a lot of hard work. Google will automatically make the results available on tablet devices and mobile devices. But where it starts for you as the business is you have to claim your business listing. Now, Google probably already knows your business exists. If your business is listed in some directory, Google probably already knows it exists. But your job and what you should do at the end of this event is claim your business. Simply do a search for it and then say, hey, Google, that's my business. I'm the business owner. There's a simple verification process Google goes through where they give your phone number a call, you pick up the phone, and you confirm that, yes, this is my business. I am the business owner. At that point, you can do some really amazing things, and this is where the power of Google My Business comes into play. You can start to enhance the listing. And so, for example, you could put on some videos. I've talked to plenty of small businesses, and whenever I talk to them, what's amazing to me is there's always a great personal story behind why that person is in business. You know, I just told you my story of becoming a wedding photographer. I've talked to lawyers who are passionate about the type of law that they practice because they met some people who were in a tough spot. They were able to help them. You know, I work with a lot of people who are in the senior care industry, in-home senior care. And when you talk to them, they usually have reasons for having gone into that business that have something to do with an elderly parent, maybe not having received the best care. And as a result, they got into that business. So if you can sit down and you can make a video that explains why you're passionate about the business, that's going to give you a leg up. Because guess what? You're not going to be the only one advertising, right? So consumers are going to compare multiple choices. And if they see your video and they make that personal connection, chances are they're going to want to do business with you. And remember, this is local, right? So if you're a lawyer, someone's going to have to come to your office and sit down face to face with you. If they've already seen a video and they feel comfortable with you, they like what you're all about, chances are so much better you're actually going to get that business. And here's a little stat about mobile as well. So 3 in 4 consumers who've done that search on their smartphone have then also contacted a local business. And so Google My Business is really the easiest way to get started with that. Now, the other thing about Google My Business is that once you take control over that listing, you can modify the phone number, your contact information, the address. One time there was a bowling alley. This was a really big building. And for some reason, Google put the pinpoint at the incorrect location on the map. So they actually had it on the correct building, but they had it on the wrong corner. So people were all driving to the faraway corner of the building, parking their car, and then figuring out they had to walk all the way around it to get to the front entrance. It wasn't the greatest experience. Very simple solution. If you're the business, the verified business owner of this Google My Business listing, then you can actually drag that pinpoint to the correct location. Now, the other thing to keep in mind is you might have seen people pulling out their phone and saying, okay, Google now, and then they start talking to their phone. So people can do voice searches, and Google did some research and found that the number one thing adults do in terms of voice search is asking for directions. How brilliant is this? I mean, these are people already out and about looking for directions to get help with some service they need or to look for some business. And so the chances that they're going to go in after doing something like that are really tremendous. So 72% of people who do that research also end up going to a store location or a service location that's within 5 miles of where they're located. So these are the things that you can really take advantage of by having those business listings. And I'll make one final point about Google My Business. And this is Google My Business enables you to participate on a social level. So here's an example. This is a big company, maybe not super relevant to you, but I'll make sure you understand how it does relate to you at the end. So McDonald's. All of a sudden, people on social networks start talking about McDonald's and they say, oh, McDonald's put maggots in their meat. It's not real meat. That's a terrible thing to say. And if you're McDonald's, well, guess what? This conversation is happening on social media, whether you're a part of that conversation or not. And so McDonald's did the right thing. McDonald's said, we're going to have a seat at the table. We want to be on social media. We're actually going to ask people, tell us what you believe about us. And then we're going to take the most common things that people say and we're going to address it in videos or in social media. And so what they've done is they've just gotten a seat at the table so that they can be part of the conversation that's happening regardless of whether you are part of it or not. By the way, 27% of time in the United States today is spent on social media. Now, how does all of that relate to you? Well, with Google My Business, you get access to being social, so you can be talking to people. But you also get access to reviews. So if someone came into your business and left a review, you can post a response to that review. And guess what? If you run a restaurant, chances are you're not 100% perfect. You're going to get some people coming in who don't like the meal. You know, maybe you were short-staffed one evening because people were sick, your servers were sick, so people didn't have the best experience. You get a couple of negative reviews. Well, that's okay. What matters more is that you respond to those negative reviews. And you, as the business owner, you show people, I care enough about my business to be looking at these reviews and to respond to them and to try to make it right by, for example, saying, hey, deeply apologize for your experience. Come in next time. An appetizer will be on the house. Now, if a consumer looks at that, and think about yourselves, right? If you look at that and you see the business owner cares enough to have that response, chances are you're going to think that's a pretty cool business. And maybe that even looks more legitimate than a business that has 100% five-star reviews. Because, you know, you and I, none of us are perfect. So we're all going to get that lower review at some point. Now, let's go back to AdWords for a second. So AdWords is really cool because it is about advertising at the moment of relevance. But what is relevant changes over time. So right now we're in the middle of winter and maybe you have an ice cream shop. Is it really the best thing to be promoting your ice cream when it's freezing outside, when Boston just got another 2 feet of snow? Probably not exactly what people are looking for. But if your ice cream shop has a cappuccino machine, well, why not change your ads dynamically to say, hey, you could come into our business now and we have some cappuccinos, we have some coffees, we have some waffles, some other things you actually might want to eat right now. Now, all of that can be automated and your agencies can help you with this. So the AdWords can be tied directly to the temperature, for example. So as the temperature hits a certain point, you could automatically flip the ads from showing ice cream to showing cappuccino or vice versa. And so it's about that moment of relevance that you're able to promote that's really going to get people in the door. Now, it's not just the weather or the temperature that you can integrate with. You can look at the stock market, movie releases, your own business data. So another classic example is, say you have a car dealership. Well, every time a used car comes onto the lot, do you sit down and do you make a new ad group for it? Or do you just want to maintain a spreadsheet, a Google Sheet, for example, where every time a new car comes on the lot, you just put in that car and it automatically feeds into AdWords? Well, these are things that can be done, right? So you don't have to be spending a tremendous amount of time managing AdWords, but you can do a whole lot of automation to really make sure the ads are the most relevant to the users at the moment that they're looking for it, and based on some outside factors like the stock market, the weather, your inventory. So those are some things you should ask your agencies about as well. Now, let's talk about mobile. And the reason we have to talk about mobile is that mobile is growing really, really quickly. And so in a recent survey, consumers were asked, would you rather go without your cell phone, without your smartphone, or without vacation? And kind of sad, but 45% of people said they would rather forego a vacation than forego their smartphone. By the way, you may have heard the term smartphone, and a lot of people don't stop to think about what this means, but a smartphone is a phone with access to the whole internet. So anything you can do at your desktop browser, you can do on a smartphone. There's no restrictions by the carriers as to which email you get to use, which web browsers you get to use. It's the whole internet in your pocket on a phone, right? And so people are really getting married to their phones, and that's why it's so important to stay ahead of this trend. Now let me give you a couple of really specific examples and use cases. So the American Cancer Society was looking at their statistics one day. They were using Google Analytics. Todd was referencing Google Analytics. And we're not going to spend a lot of time on this, but just know Google Analytics is a free product that will tell you what people do when they come to your website. So American Cancer Society sits down with their data, and they see that there's a growing number of people who are coming to their website from mobile devices. But they also notice that these people are not having the best experience. They have high bounce rates. They don't visit a lot of pages. And so they start trying to figure out what's happening. Why are people not having that best experience? They use Google Analytics to figure out that people on mobile devices tend to be researching different types of cancer than people on desktop computers. And so all of these differences in behavior, but the most important thing to them was the fact that very few people were making donations on mobile sites, on the mobile devices. And that's concerning because if the donations dry up, then their business is going to be in a really tough spot. And as the desktop usage declines and mobile picks up, if you're doing well in this shrinking segment, well, who cares, right? You have to do well in the growing segment, which is the mobile segment. So they sat down and they said, we're going to take all 7,000 of our pages, we're going to make them mobily accessible, really useful to watch on mobile devices. And guess what? Their mobile usage went up, and also the number of mobile donations went up. So not only are they growing the number of people coming to their site on mobile devices above and beyond what would naturally happen, but they're also getting more donations. So now their business is really healthy again because they've taken a look at Google Analytics and they've understood that for them, mobile is really, really important and they've gotten ahead of that trend. Now, here's another company. This one is PlusNet. They sell home broadband connections. Similar position as the American Cancer Society, they noticed people were not having a good experience on mobile devices and not a lot of people were converting on mobile devices. And here was the problem. They had built a website knowing that people's monitors were getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So they crammed a ton of information on their website, but they hadn't really sat down and thought about what is the most important piece of information that our users need. And then when people started to look at these websites on mobile devices, they were showing the exact same thing. So people had to pinch and zoom a lot to be able to read the text. They had to scroll and scroll and scroll and scroll and keep scrolling before they found what they were looking for. So this was a bad thing. They knew they needed to change this. They had two options. They could have either designed a completely new site for mobile, but that would have taken a second product team to manage it, a new engineering team. It would have been a whole new project, so a lot of resources in that. Or they could have done a responsive design. And responsive design is simply some newer technologies like HTML5 and CSS3. Your agencies know all about these, so you can ask them about that. But the responsive design basically says, depending on what type of device, what screen size the user goes to, we're going to show the same site, but with the correct layout so that they're easy to use. So that's the first thing they did. The second thing they did is they said, we're going to take a mobile-first approach in the way that we think about our website. So rather than just jamming everything on it and not really giving thought to what is most important, let's take a step back. Let's start with a blank slate and figure out what needs to be on that site to give our consumers what they're looking for. So they did that, and to their surprise, not only was the mobile site performance better, but their desktop site also started performing better because they had actually given thought to what was being shown on that page. And so some really amazing stats there around how much faster people were finding what they were looking for and how many more sales they were getting. And so the beauty then is, as you start having this great mobile experience, you can actually start to buy ads in AdWords that drive more and more traffic to the mobile experience. You can start capturing this whole new group of people on their mobile devices, and you can start monetizing those. Now, another thing happened, and this is with a company called Connection. They do credit repair for consumers. And what they noticed was that people who called in after having visited the mobile website were at a very different stage of readiness to buy than people who'd been to the desktop site. And at first they couldn't understand what was happening, but then they sat down and they said, oh, it actually makes sense. If someone's only seen our mobile site, maybe they haven't spent quite as much time. Maybe they haven't read as much. Because on a mobile device, honestly, you don't want to read that much. So you might call and you might expect the person who picks up the phone to do most of the selling to you and to explain what's happening. Whereas someone on a desktop device probably has done a bunch of research and they're ready to buy. So don't bore them with all the details. Just get their information and help them get what they want. So once they realize this, they put two different service teams in place, two different sales scripts almost. And all of a sudden, their results really started booming. So they had a 221% increase in that 1 year. And because they were doing so much better on mobile, all of a sudden, they could actually invest more money in advertising. And that was a self-fueling mechanism then, right? They started growing bigger and bigger. So those are a couple of ideas on mobile and some things that you might be able to do for your business. Now, final section, tracking everything. Again, this is about the old adage that you've probably heard way too many times, but it says 50% of your ad budget is being wasted. It's just we don't know which half, so you have to keep doing more and more of it. Well, that's not the case with online. With online, it's beautiful because every single click that happens, every single call that happens is trackable. We know what happens. We know whether that led to a sale, a newsletter sign up, a person contacting you. Now, the thing is, when it comes to online businesses, you know, think about your Amazons, what they consider a conversion is very, very different from what you as a local business think of as a conversion. You probably want more phone calls rather than people just clicking to your site. So the good news is Google makes this really easy. They have a free product which does call tracking. Not only can Google show a dynamic phone number in the ad text, they can now also show that dynamic phone number on your landing pages. So in the past, people would see the ad, maybe call directly from the ad, and Google would say this was the keyword that led to that person calling. But if that person went onto your website, then that connection was lost. But now that's not the case anymore. Now Google shows a custom number, which they can track back to an individual click. And so based on that, they can say, okay, this is the keyword that drove a lot of calls. And what do you do as a business with that? Well, you say, if this keyword, I spent $100 and I got 5 calls from it, maybe that's really good, so I'm going to spend more money on that keyword. And this other keyword, I spent $100 and I got 0 calls, well, maybe I'm going to bid less for that, or I'm going to stop advertising on that one altogether. So it puts you as the advertiser in control, and it gives you access to the data you need to know what's success for you. So the other thing that happens in online, though, is that oftentimes the connection gets lost. So as the user goes between a mobile device and a desktop device, maybe they're out and about, and they do repetitive searches or they keep on researching, you might lose track of the original cookie that belonged to that user. So the good news is Google came up with this metric called estimated total conversions. The estimated total conversions use some really sophisticated models whereby Google can estimate how many people actually bought something from you, how many people called you up, how many people converted, regardless of what your conversion type is. Now, just in the last month or so, Google even introduced this really cool new technology that can track an estimate of how many people did a search and then physically came to your store where it is likely they bought something. And they can do this using GPS on mobile phones, and so they can do some estimates based on that to really give you a more complete picture of how many sales, how many leads are you getting for every dollar that you're spending. And again, because of this data, you can advertise and you can be confident that the advertising money is well spent and that you're not just wasting it. Now, at the end of the day, keep in mind that you want to have a great, great presence on that search results page. Even if you don't drive the most direct response, if you can have a great organic result, if you can have a great result on Google Maps coming from Google My Business, if you're buying AdWords ads to have that the ad at the top of the page or maybe on the right-hand side of the page, all of that is building up your business's credibility in the minds of consumers. And even if it doesn't lead to a sale today, you know, we've seen this time and again, people's perspective on your brand is growing. It's becoming better. So over time, you'll eventually get that customer to come in and do business with you. So that kind of puts it all in perspective. And with that, I would love to turn it back over to Scott and thank you very much for your time today.
Thank you, Fred. I know personally, I'd rather be a part of the group that loses the smartphone rather than gives up their vacation.
Yeah, me too.
But I do want to remind everyone that the true experts today are really the AdWords partners. So your Google partners in the room. They work with AdWords every single day, and ask them questions and give them specifics about your business, and they can create a specific plan to how your business can be successful using AdWords analytics, Google My Business, to capture these customers and use the techniques that Fred's been talking about. So I want to thank everyone for coming here today. I hope you enjoyed the content. Have a great day.